on MNG. I would like to now invite Professor P.S. Shanti from Madras Medical College on stage.
Good morning, sir. I'm Dr. Haripriya from Chettinad Medical College.
And I'm Dr. Divya from Chettinad Medical College. We are here to present a case on MNG. A 50-year-old female came to our hospital with chief complaints of swelling in the neck for the past 7 years. History of presenting illness, patient was apparently normal before 7 years, after which she developed swelling in the middle of the neck, which is slowly increasing in size, initially and now increased in size a little faster for the past 4 months, not associated with pain. No history suggestive of hyperthyroidism or hypothyroidism or malignant features. Menstrual history, attained menopause 1 year ago. Personal history, history of calcium supplementation for the past.
Just 1 minute. Complaints repeated. Go previous slide. That's very important history you told. So any other questions I have to ask? This. So recently suddenly increase in size, no? So any other questions I have to ask?
It was not a rapid increase in size, sir. It was just a little faster compared to her previous rate of growth.
So what do you mean? This is not rapid. What do you mean? Where do you get confused?
Slowly increasing size. Faster means what is the meaning of faster?
Suddenly, initially.
Rapid increase only, no?
Increase in size means rapidly. Okay, doesn't matter. If you, okay, because you must stand, what you say is must be correct. The diagnosis is also very important. Anyway, but what are the, supposed to be, you have to ask the questions in the case of thyroid. So generally, you have to ask questions. No hypothyroidism, no hyper, okay. Any other questions in this case? You have to ask the question.
Any other swelling elsewhere in the
very
neck?
Good. Any other swellings in the neck? What does it mean? Why should I ask this question?
If you are considering any malignancy, cervical inferinopathies.
Okay. Any other questions?
History of loss of weight, history of loss of appetite, and
see, when there is a rapid increase in size, we expect some symptoms, pressure symptoms, no?
History of stridor, history of any hoarseness of voice, history of dysphagia, history of any dyspnea, and
yeah, that certainly had to ask the questions.
Important history you should have asked, no? When there is a rapid increase in size.
Any other questions? So, pressure symptoms you have to ask. Metastatic symptoms, already you told. So, you have to know that. Any other questions you have to ask? History of regression.
There's no
history. Or suppose the regression is present, what does it mean? What's the possibility? What are the possibilities if regression occurs? What's the importance? So one of the malignancy of the thyroid, regression may occur. Physiological goiter also regression occur. Which type of malignancy of the thyroid, regression occurs? Give the clue. So running in the family also. Medullary carcinoma of the thyroid. So you have to ask all the questions, okay? So don't forget the basic things.
And in your clinical photo, you have to hide the eyes, not the mouth.
So we thought eye signs we can see so good.
So in a case of thyroid, what or any midline swelling for that matter, what are all the things which you immediately ask? One is hypothyroidism, two hyperthyroidism. You said malignancy features. You haven't given the details of the what all you have asked. Or anything positive?
No, ma'am, nothing was positive.
Nothing is
toxic
positive.
Features, we can ask for toxic features.
Yes. Next thing which you have to mention about is the pressure effects immediately. That is the over the trachea, over the esophagus, and laterally you have the nerves. So that, anything?
History of hoarseness of voice and stridor and dysphagia. If patients
actually, the stridor is not a feature of malignancy. It's a change in voice, it's a feature of malignancy. Stridor, usually you will get only in anaplastic carcinoma of thyroid. It's a short duration and you will get a stridor. Understand? And all other malignancies, you will get a change in voice.
There's There's no toxic symptoms, ma'am. No, okay, no issue of.
Proceed.
Proceed. Proceed.
Yes.
Past history. She's a known case of hypothyroidism.
Close to the mic.
Past history. She's a known case of hypothyroidism for past 7 years and was on tablet taltroxin 50 mcg. And the patient was diagnosed to have hyperthyroidism 6 months ago and started in tablet carbamazole 5 mg and tablet propranolol 40 mg, which she took for 3 months and discontinued. She consulted a local physician and was started again on tablet eltroxin. History of bronchial asthma and interstitial lung disease for which she was on treatment
for last two months.
Previous history, history of appendectomy in childhood and sterilization 30 years ago. History of right eye surgery 1 year ago. Family history is not significant.
On examination, the patient is poorly built and poorly nourished. There's pallor is present, cyanosis is present. Cyanosis is absent, there's clubbing is present. Bilateral pitting pedal edema mildly present. No facial swelling or no eye signs are present. BP is 120/80 mmHg and pulse rate is 72 per minute. Good volume, normal rhythm, no radioradial and no radio femoral delay. Skin is inelastic and it's not dry. Local examination, on inspection, butterfly shaped swelling, which was uniform swelling on the center of the neck, was present approximately 7 into 5 centimeters anteriorly. Lower border was 1 centimeter from the sternal notch on each side, and upper border was 7 centimeter from the sternal notch on the right side and 5 centimeter from the sternal notch on the left side. Lateral border up to the sternocleidomastoid border on both sides. Medially up to the midline it can be seen. Size approximately 9 centimeters across the swelling. The swelling moves up with deglutition. It does moves upward with deglutation. It does not move with the protrusion of the trunk. Lower border of the swelling is visible. Trachea appears midline in position. No other visible swellings and no other pulsatile swellings are present. On palpation, there's no warmth, no tenderness. Inspectory findings were confirmed. Lower border of the swelling was palpable. Firm in consistency, bosselated surface. On examination by Lahey's method, multiple lobules were present in both lobes, largest measuring 1x1 cm. It was mobile in all directions, laterally extends up to the sternocleidomastoid. Coach's test is negative. Trachea is in midline. Carotid position felt in normal position.
On what test you said?
Coach's test, sir. Caucus.
Caucus.
Caucus test. No Horner syndrome or myxedema features. Non-pulsatile, no thrill, no cervical lymphadenopathy, no tremors. On auscultation, there's no bruhi which is present. Anatomical diagnosis is...
Before that, what do you say is a box letter? What's the size of this only? What's the size of this only?
So, swelling was approximately 7x9 cm, sir.
That's why you are telling. What do you mean, bosselated? When do you use the word bosselated? That's why you have to understand what you say. Is it, when do you say bosselated? 7 cm is a bosselated? What do you mean, bosselated? Bosselated means biggest size. So, for example, anaplastic carcinomas. So, more than 10 or 15 centimeters, very large size. That is a boss letter. But don't use this word boss letter. Where does it move with the deglutition?
Because of the it
close
originates
the
from
close to the mic.
It originates from the tongue, sir, initially. So
pardon?
Pardon?
In embryology it forms from the tongue.
So unnecessarily you want to ask another question. Embryological development.
Why it moves with deglutition?
Tell us embryological development of thyroid gland. Embryological development. First you had finished embryologically. Okay, proceed. After that, why does it move with the deglutition?
Anterior two-third and posterior one-third of the tongue, it develops from there, sir, and descends downward towards the neck.
What?
See, usually bosselated surface normally we used to say in lipoma and cystosarcoma, not in other thyroid case. Usually you can say it's a nodular size of varying size from 2 cm or whatever size here. Don't use the word here, bosselated surface. It's not necessary.
What are the signs of hyperthyroidism? You look, this
finish the embryo.
Deglutition first.
No, embryological development. Finish. You also can join. You also can join embryological development. What's the name of the substance, embryological substance, which is developed and further downwards? Well, this is very important in thyroglossal cyst. So this question is very important. Okay, why does it move with the deglutition? It's a very important question, no? Everybody has to know the answer. So thyroid gland covered by?
True and false capsule, sir. True capsule is... false capsule is formed by the anterior and posterior division of the deep cervical fascia. The true capsule is formed, it's a fibrous structure which is closely adherent to the thyroid gland. So posteriorly, it's condensed to form the Berry's ligament.
Hmm. Then, so Berry's ligament, where it goes?
Because of the
Berry's ligaments, it moves up.
Berry's ligament going to attach to the thyroid membrane. The thyroid membrane is going to attach to the thyroid cartilage and the hyoid bone. So everybody have to know the answers. Why does it move to the deglutition? Okay. Proceed. What's your diagnosis?
Anatomical diagnosis is swelling, thyroid swelling. And clinical diagnosis is non-toxic, non-malignant, multinodular goiter, sir.
Do you want to say any other diagnosis? The only one, definitely. Why suddenly change in size? What's the possibility?
Even in multinodular goiter, sometimes there can be a rapid increase in size, a little faster increase in size, rather than rapid increase in size.
Which type of malignancy is very common?
Follicular.
So this history is very important. So according to the history complaints, your diagnosis must be. Don't say simply, then unnecessary, why is a suddenly increase in size? That's very important. Okay. So,
long-standing multinodular goiter, what type of malignancy it can change?
Follicular carcinoma.
Follicular carcinoma of thyroid. So always it's better to give a differential diagnosis, you know. See, non-toxic, non-malignant, that's fine. And the patient was under treatment for hyperthyroidism, is it?
Yes, so 6 months back, she was diagnosed to have hyperthyroidism and started...
Then why they started L-Troxin?
Outside, sir. Locally, she went to a local... She discontinued the drugs because she was not able to get the drugs, sir. After 3 months, she again went to a local physician where TFT was done and patient was found to be in hypothyroid state again, sir. So she was started on L-Troxin.
She was on treatment for hyperthyroidism. What are the signs of hyperthyroidism you looked for clinically?
Clinically, tremors, ma'am. There were no tremors. No tremors in the neck or in the tongue. And there were no eye signs which was present, ma'am.
You didn't mention anything about the eye signs when you presented. This is why I'm asking again.
I mentioned in the general examination as no
general
eye
examination.
Signs
okay, then?
Then patient will have... in history, she'll give history of, she can give history of insomnia and history of
insomnia and
depressed.
At present,
state.
No toxicity, is it?
No, sir.
When you examine, no signs of toxicity.
No signs of toxicity by present. Sir.
Okay, right. You proceed for investigation.
Investigation. I'd like to do a TFT initially, sir, and a USG neck, and followed by anti-thyroid antibodies and FNAC for this patient. After which we'd like to, if the TFT is in normal, patient is in euthyroid state, then we'd like to proceed with surgery, sir.
So you don't want to rule out malignancy at all in this patient? Sudden increase in size?
USG neck we would do, ma'am. If there's any...
What are the signs of malignancy you can suspect from USG of the neck?
Increased vascularity, if there's any increase in size of one of the nodules specifically. Then
see, first of all, ultrasound finding, TFT you said to find out whether it's a hyper or hypo or... patient is in euthyroid clinically. What are the findings you expect in ultrasound neck?
We can find out the number of nodules which are palpable, sir. Because
yes.
Which are palpable, it can differ from USG, sir. Even nodules of size 0.3 centimeters can be found.
Anything else? Other number of nodules then?
Then we can also find if there's any other cervical lymph nodes which are not palpable, sir.
Only nodes.
Can you be
regarding
more specific
the
about the nodules? What are the other points you can look for in the nodules? One is size of the nodule, whether cystic or solid lesions. Then calcification is there, that you can say that. Then?
Vascularity, sir.
Vascularity. Next?
Echogenicity will you look for?
Yes, ma'am.
Hmm. You have to look for echogenicity, is it? So what echogenicity you expect here?
Benign usually will be hyperechoic and malignant will be hypoechoic. Benign will be hyperechoic and malignant will usually be hypoechoic.
Okay, then regarding the node, presence of multiple lymph nodes or how many number of nodes then? Which one is more important, presence of node, size of the node, anteroposterior diameter of the node, everything you should know in ultrasound neck. Then why you want to do your antithyroid antibodies? You are not suspecting any toxicity in your diagnosis. You said it's a non-toxic, then why you want to do your antithyroid antibodies?
Because in history there's a...
But clinically you said euthyroid state, is it so? So no need to do antithyroid antibodies. What are the indications for antithyroid antibodies? Just
if you are suspecting thyroiditis or any
thyroiditis or in hyperthyroidism, you can go for it. Otherwise, it's not necessary. Regarding FNAC, what type of FNAC you want to do here? There are solid lesions, there are cystic lesions there in ultrasonogram. Where you want to take FNAC, solid or cystic?
Solid, sir.
Only in solid lesion, under ultrasound guided or without ultrasound?
USG guided, sir.
Always under ultrasound guided FNAC, that's 100% proof. Yes. So what are the points you want to know from cytologist in FNAC? Imagine it's a multinodular goiter. So what type of FNAC finding you have?
Will you be able to differentiate malignancy itself from FNAC? That's what sir is asking.
So what type of cell you get in thyroid?
Follicular cells.
Follicular cells. Okay, then?
Parafollicular cells can also be present, sir.
Parafollicular cells. No. In multinodular goiter.
Follicular cells and colloids, sir.
Colloids,
sir.
With colloid. Okay, then? Any cystic gene degeneration, they can say that. Then, what's the finding for papillary carcinoma of thyroid? Follicular carcinoma, can you diagnose here in FNAC?
See, you cannot diagnose follicular carcinoma by FNAC.
Because we don't know if it's...
They can say only follicular...
benign or malignant...
They can say only follicular adenoma. They cannot differentiate, as you know very well. What is the finding for papillary carcinoma of thyroid in FNAC? Hypercellularity. Then, hypercellularity. Then, anything else? Why follicular carcinoma cannot be differentiated, that you can say, is it?
Yes, sir, because of the, we can't know if it's the basement membrane is...
Capsular invasion
is present or not.
Capsular invasion or vascular invasion cannot be differentiated from? In FNAC, which you cannot diagnose. One point for follicular. So that is why you're not able to diagnose follicular carcinoma. Regarding papillary carcinoma, what are the points? What's the important finding in follicular? Hypercellularity, one thing. Any other thing? In medullary?
Okay, any other investigation? This case, only ultrasound is enough. Any other investigation?
Video laryngoscopy, sir.
Napa?
Video laryngoscope or...
Video laryngoscope.
Okay. What about CT neck? Is it useful or not, this patient? Yes, CT sir. Neck. What's the advantage than, rather than ultrasound? How do you take a CT neck?
We can know about the nodal status if there's any tracheomalacia or anything. Hmm. And for tracheal deviations, we can...
less than 1 centimeter can pick up by the CT. And also there is any infiltration of the tumor near the structures, carotid or anything. So placement of carotid, position of the carotid, that's a very important for the surgeons. That's why you have to sit. The treatment, what's the treatment for this patient?
We'll do total thyroidectomy, sir.
What?
Total thyroidectomy.
Total thyroidectomy. Okay. So before that, this patient, history is very important. So already you said the patient taking anti-thyroid drugs. So masking of hyperthyroidism. Even though the patient is getting anti-thyroid, you have to say this is a secondary thyrotoxicosis. This your case is a diagnosis of secondary thyroid. Don't say non-toxic. That's very important. It's a lot of controversy you are making. So findings, pertaining to the findings, your diagnosis must be very important. So you are missing off that one. So another one is the suddenly increase in size, there's a possibility of transformation of the malignancy. So most common is a follicular carcinoma. Even now anaplastic carcinoma also very common. We have seen so many cases, anaplastic. So long standing become anaplastic carcinoma. So this case is very, very important. So recent advance of investigations also you have to know. What is the thyroid scintigraphy? You are aware of it, thyroid scintigraphy? What is the thyroid scintigraphy? What is that? Radioactive iodine 131 with MIBG scan. What is that MIBG? Metoiodobenzyl gonadine. What's the advantage of thyroid scintigraphy?
We'll be able to find out if there's any hot.
Pardon?
Nodule. Any cold nodule or hot nodules?
Yes. Any other thing? Thyrotoxicosis or malignancy. So thyroid scintigraphy, especially it's medullary carcinoma thyroid. So you have to know the recent advance of anything.
So you have done total thyroidectomy, reported as follicular carcinoma of thyroid. How will you proceed?
We have to check for the lymph node if they...
Follicular carcinoma of thyroid. What's the mode of spread for follicular?
Hematogenous, sir. Hematogenous.
Hematogenous. Blood spread. You're final year, no? Final APG. Which
second,
year?
Second year, sir.
Yes, you can answer. What's the mode of spread for follicular? See, suppose if it is a follicular carcinoma, then you have to do a follow-up. How will you follow-up? Immediate post-operative period, you have to do a thyroglobulin study, then thyroid profile. The thyroglobulin assay is very important for follow-up, future follow-up. So if thyroglobulin is there, then you can assess in future also every year, every subsequent visit for 3 months. Every 3 months, you have to do a thyroglobulin assay. Then you have to go for a thyroid uptake scan. Suppose if you do a thyroid uptake scan, suppose if the spread is to the, where it goes mainly, follicular carcinoma. Usually bony metastasis is very common. Suppose if there is a bony metastasis, then you have to ablate with radioiodine. Radioiodine. The dose of radioiodine is more than 30 millicuries. Only for diagnostic, it is microcuries. For ablation, it is millicuries. Then you have to give a single dose of radioiodine ablation. So wherever there is a thyroid secondaries in the bone, it will destroy. Then you have to follow the patient every 6 months with thyroglobulin assay. If it is increased, then you have to repeat uptake. Understand? What's the most dreaded complication is follicular carcinoma is fracture. Fracture bone is very, very common there. Patient can have a multiple fractures at any number of times in subsequent years. So always follow-up is very important.
So, is there any malignancy post-operatively? What's the investigation you want to do after total thyroidectomy? The few seconds, you have to know. Say any residual, say recurrence? The summarize. Summarizes. So summarize of these patients is very important. History-wise, the patients are suddenly increase in size. And also the past history, the patients are having hypothyroidism. After that, the drug-induced thyrotoxicosis. Thyrotoxicosis, that's why the patients are getting anti-thyroid drugs. So the patients develop drug-induced hyperthyroidism. That's another interesting history. So the eye signs are masking off eye signs, everything. So the, finally the diagnosis, what's the diagnosis? This patient, repeat once again, what's the diagnosis? Revise.
Non-toxic malignant.
Okay, that's okay. Okay, thank you. So the post-operative, that's one of the investigations, radioactive iodine uptake. That's very important, residual thyroid present or not. The another one is a thyroid immunoglobulin level. That's a very important. Thank you. Thank you for giving opportunity.